Cathy and Heathcliff were thick, right from the start. Wuthering Heights was not always the place you see today. That blackened prison on a bleak hill, where wind blows so hard the trees grow at a slant. On a sunny day, light spilled over the white stone floor and the huge glowing fireplace. There were rows of shining pewter dishes and silver jugs and tankards, and they towered as high as the roof. And after rain, I remember this, there was always the sweet sound of the beck flowing in the valley. It was a fine summer morning. We were eating our porridge in the kitchen when old Mr. Earnshaw came down dressed for a journey.
Father?
Where are you going?
I have affairs in Liverpool. Joseph, you'll look after the harvest while I'm gone.
Aye, sir.
Now then, Hindley, what shall I bring you?
A horse. A chestnut.
It's 60 miles there and back. Choose what you like, but let it be small.
A fiddle.
Very well, I'll fetch you a fiddle. What about you, Cathy? A doll?
Nah.
Well, what then?
A whip.
What does a little girl want with a whip?
I can ride any horse in the stable. Can't I, Nelly?
She can, sir.
I want a whip.
Oh, it seemed a long time. The 3 days of Mr. Earnshaw's absence.
Is he back yet? Will he be back before tea?
Give over, Cathy.
And often did little Cathy ask when he would be home.
Will he be back if I stand
at last
by
she got door? Tired of running to the gate to look, and it grew dark. The old servant, Joseph, took out his Bible. At about 11 o'clock, the door latch was raised.
Father!
Oh, don't crowd me. I'm dead on my feet.
Did you get me fiddle?
Oh, something better than a fiddle. Look what I've got. You must take it as a gift of God, even though it's dark as the devil.
Beneath his coat, he was hiding a ragged, black-haired child. Big enough to walk and talk. Indeed, its face looked older than Cathy's. Yet, when the old master set it on its feet, it only stared and repeated some gibberish that no one could understand.
Hannah Barton.
It's all right.
Hannah Barton.
What's it saying?
It's a gypsy. It's not saying nothing.
I found it on the street. I couldn't leave it. It was the Christian thing to do.
You don't need more mouths to feed and fend for. These two are enough trouble as it is.
Oh. Say hello, Hindley.
I won't.
Say hello, Cathy.
Hello.
It likes you. Shame on you, Cathy Earnshaw. Lassies, don't spit. Wash it, Nelly. Give it a good clean.
Yes, sir.
You can sleep with Hindley.
But Hindley would not have it in bed with him. He wouldn't even have it in the room.
Stay out, brat! I don't want you. Get back on the street where he found you.
I put it on top of the stairs and hoped it might be gone in the morning.
Are you scared? Do you understand? Are you cold? Listen. Number two, some wear a boot but I wear a shoe. Oh, you like that, do you? Come on, you can share with me.
He was christened Heathcliff, after a son of Earnshaw's that had died. And from then on, it was always the same.
Where are you? Come on!
It was always Heathcliff following Cathy.
That's a pigeon feather. Say it. Pigeon. That's it. Pigeon. You can have it if you like. That's a lapwing. Lap. Wing. Lapwing. Lapwing. You can have that one and all. Look at your hand. Look at mine. See? Yours is all dark and mine is all white, but on the other side, they're both the same.
Oh, don't! Don't tickle me!
Lapwing!
Stop! Lapwing! Stop!
As time passed, Hindley learnt to regard Heathcliff as a usurper both of his father's love and his privileges.
Now then, bonny lads, I have two new horses. Choose which one you'd like.
The chestnut, father.
Heathcliff?
The chestnut.
Heathcliff, you shall have the chestnut. Hindley, you can have the other.
I don't want the other.
How many times do I have to say it? We must show charity.
So Heathcliff took the chestnut, but it soon fell lame. He went straight back to Hindley.
I want yours.
You can't have mine.
Show your father what you did to my arm.
You gypsy!
Go on, hit me! I don't care!
Down Heathcliff fell, but staggered up immediately, breathless and white.
Again!
You dog!
Again!
I hate you!
Hindley, get off!
Take my horse. I hope he breaks your neck.
In the course of time, Mr. Earnshaw's health began to fail, and he grew irritable.
Can no one speak? How did he get these bruises? Heathcliff? Hindley? Cathy? Nellie Dean, what about you?
I saw nothing, sir. My back was turned.
You should flog them all. They're all as wicked.
There are going to be some changes from now on. Hindley, I'm sending you to college.
I don't want to go. I want to stay here.
You're good for nothing here. And Cathy, go say thy prayers and ask God's pardon.
Good night, Father.
I rue the day I ever reared you. Good lad, Heathcliff.
Bye, Hindley. Bye.
I hope we might have peace at last. Now that Hindley was away, Heathcliff and Cathy were always together.
Run,
it was their chief pleasure to run away to the moor in the morning and remain there all day.
Number five,
a so wild slip she was, full of life. She was never so happy as when we were scolding her. But she was much too fond of Heathcliff. The greatest punishment we could invent for her was to keep her separate from him.
Let me in!
Not until you say your prayers!
I don't want to say my prayers! I want to see Heathcliff! Nellie! Let me in!
Oh, wicked! Wicked! May the Lord deliver us from evil! You'll never mend your ill ways, but go straight to the devil!
It was 3 years later, when the hour came at last, that ended Mr. Earnshaw's life. I was busy at my knitting by the fireside, and Joseph was reading the Bible.
For if they fall, one will lift up the other.
Miss Cathy leant against her father's knee, and Heathcliff lay on the floor, with his head in her lap.
Why canst thou not always be a good lass, Cathy?
Why can't you always be a good man, Father? Shall I sing?
Aye.
It was one summer morning, as I rambled o'er yon moss, I had no thought of listing, till a soldier did me cross. Father?
Don't wake him.
Father!
Joseph sent me to fetch the parson. And it was midnight by the time I went up to the children. Their door was open, but they'd not gone to sleep.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.